So my name is Markus Glatzel. I am the director of the Institute of Neuropathology at the University Medical Center here in Hamburg-Eppendorf in Germany.
My name is Diego Sepulveda-Falla. I am a postdoc researcher in Alzheimer in the same institute.
My institute focuses on unraveling the events underlying neurodegeneration. Now, we would like to introduce our paper, soon to be published in JCI. Our study is aimed at gaining new insights into the molecular events leading to cerebellar dysfunction in familial Alzheimer disease. Let us first recapitulate how Alzheimer disease is believed to be initiated. A key player and a key component responsible for neurodegeneration in Alzheimer disease is the short peptide beta amyloid. Beta amyloid is generated by sequential proteolytic cleavage of a larger transmembrane protein, APP, short for amyloid precursor protein. Two proteolytic events, one by the protease base and one by gamma secretase, a multi-protein complex, liberate beta amyloid. Beta amyloid aggregates in the brain, leading to neurodegeneration. The key component of gamma secretase is presenilin-1.
The vast majority of AD cases are of a sporadic nature. However, there are some patients that inherit AD. Most of familial Alzheimer's disease is caused by mutations in the presenilin genes. In Colombia, South America, it is localized, the largest kindred in the world carrying a single mutation in the presenilin-1 gene with around 500 affected individuals. It is known that some familial Alzheimer's disease cases present with cerebellar dysfunction. We took advantage of the size of this population in order to identify the characteristics of this phenotype. We found that before the onset of dementia, mutant carriers already show abnormal motor performance and that half of familial Alzheimer's demented patients suffer from cerebellar ataxia.
Using morphological methods, we were able to correlate the clinical findings to neuropathological features. In cerebella of familial Alzheimer disease patients, we found a substantial loss of Purkinje cells and presence of abnormal mitochondria. Interestingly, these features were not correlated to the presence of beta amyloid, as this could be detected in familial Alzheimer disease and sporadic Alzheimer disease cerebella. Furthermore, in contrast to sporadic Alzheimer disease neurons, in cerebella of familial Alzheimer disease patients, we found loss of the interface between endoplasmic reticulum and mitochondria.
Those results motivated us to study mitochondrial proteins using biochemical methods. In effect, we found dysregulation of a normal distribution of mitochondrial transport proteins in neurons of familial Alzheimer's disease patients. It is to be noted that this kind of mitochondrial transport is regulated by calcium.
This finding was highly interesting because published in vitro studies relate mutations in presenilin-1 to abnormal calcium homeostasis. Thus, we studied expression of calcium-related proteins in the cerebellum and found that both calcium channels IP3R and CAGNA1A were severely decreased in familial Alzheimer's disease.
Dysregulation of IP3R channels is interesting because this molecule plays a role in ER mitochondrial interface and mitochondrial calcium dynamics. Using a neuronal cell culture model, we found that presenilin-1 mutants show abnormal mitochondrial ER colocalization, abnormal mitochondrial transport, and under calcium stress conditions, we found the same proteins decrease as in the human situation.
My name is Chris DeZero. I'm chair of the Department of Neuroscience at Erasmus MC and vice director of the Netherlands Institute for Neuroscience in Amsterdam. We learned two important things of the human studies in the patients with familial Alzheimer's disease. The first thing is that the cerebellar symptoms that they showed, the motor problems, occurred at a relatively early stage. Then the second thing was that calcium-related proteins such as the voltage-gated PQ type channels encoded by the CACNA1A gene, that they are reduced. Now, the combination of the two led us to hypothesize that actually the Purkinje cell activity of the patients should be affected, and that this leads to the motor deficits long before the degeneration occurs. To study this, we took the mouse model, the PS1 mutant mouse model, and studied both their behavior and their electrophysiological properties. We tested their behavior using the Erasmus letter. The Erasmus letter was developed here, and it can be used to study at a very sensitive level both motor performance and motor learning. For example, you can see that the step time will be affected, will be enhanced and prolonged when the motor performance is not doing well. We found that both motor performance and motor learning was affected in these mice. Then we studied in the locomotor region of the cerebellum, we studied the electrophysiological properties of the Purkinje cells, and we showed that the simple spike activity of the Purkinje cells were significantly reduced, which is a phenomenon that we have often found in other degeneration models of the cerebellum, in that they precede, so the simple spike activity is reduced before the cells actually die. So, taken together, we found the mechanism that underlies the motor problems in the patients. And I think this is an important point because it will allow us to diagnose the disease at a relatively early stage with relatively simple tests, such as tests for motor behavior.
To summarize our study, we found that in familial Alzheimer disease, but not in sporadic Alzheimer disease, cerebellar symptoms are common. Cerebellar of familial Alzheimer disease patients show signs of neurodegeneration. Since beta amyloid is present in roughly equal amounts in sporadic Alzheimer disease and familial Alzheimer disease cerebellar, it is unlikely that this effect is linked to beta amyloid per se. Mutated presenilin-1 leads to disturbed calcium homeostasis, affecting mitochondrial ER contact and mitochondrial transport. We propose a dual function for mutated presenilin-1 in familial Alzheimer disease. On the one hand, enhancing beta amyloid production, but on the other hand, leading to disturbed calcium homeostasis, both events leading to neurodegeneration.